अस्सलामु अलैकुम। वी कंटिन्यू विद द टॉपिक विद द प्रीवियस टॉपिक ऑफ थ्योरीज ऑफ कैटालिसिस। वी हैड डिस्कस द फर्स्ट थ्योरी विच वाज थ्योरी ऑफ इंटरमीडिएट कंपाउंड फॉर्मेशन और इंटरमीडिएट कंपाउंड फॉर्मेशन थ्योरी। टुडे वी डिस्कस द सेकेंड थ्योरी ऑफ कैटालिसिस which is called the adsorption theory of catalysis. There are two theories of catalysis: theory of intermediate compound formation and adsorption theory. Adsorption theory was proposed by Ambrogio, Fusinieri and Faraday. Now this theory basically explains the heterogeneous catalysis. In which we study the adsorption of gases on solids or the adsorption of solutes from solution or liquids on solids. This theory involves five steps. There are five steps in this theory. The first step is the diffusion of gases onto the solid surface, onto the solid, diffusion of gases. Second, the gases get adsorbed onto the surface of the solid, adsorption of gases or liquids on the solid. This may be either Fizi's option or Kemi's option. Third step, a chemical reaction takes place between the molecules which are present closer to each other on the surface, and a complex is formed. Intermediate complex is formed. Chemical reaction between molecules on neighboring sides leading to chemical reaction, leading to the formation of intermediate complex. Fourth, decomposition of complex to form products. And fifth, desorption of the product from catalyst and its diffusion away from the catalyst surface. So these are the steps. First step is diffusion of gases into the solid. Second, adsorption of gases on the solid surface. It may be either physical adsorption or chemical adsorption. The third step is chemical reaction between molecules on the neighboring sides leading to the formation of intermediate complex which is held through partial bonds to the solid. Fourth step is the decomposition of the intermediate complex to form products, and the fifth step is the products are desorbed from the surface and they diffuse away from the solid surface. Now to study these steps, let us consider an example. Example is the hydrogenation of alkene to produce alkanes in the presence of nickel catalyst. Now first step is that we have a nickel catalyst and these are the hydrogen gas and alkene, ethene, which are passed over the nickel catalyst. Now they diffuse over the nickel catalyst and move into the, and they are adsorbed on the surface of the catalyst, as well as they may move into the interior of the catalyst through creaks or cracks in the catalyst. Now here we have hydrogen and ethene, they are adsorbed on the catalyst. Diffusion, first step is diffusion, second is adsorption. Either these may be adsorbed on the surface through chemical bonds or through van der Waals forces. Third step is the reaction to form an intermediate complex. Here we have a chemical reaction leading to formation of complex. Formation of intermediate complex, and this intermediate complex may be held through partial bonds. It may be held to the catalyst through partial bonds. Now, decomposition of the catalyst takes place. Decomposition of the product intermediate complex takes place, and the product is formed, which is ethane. Fourth step is decomposition leading to product formation, and the fifth step is desorption and diffusion of the product. The product or ethane, which is formed on the surface of the catalyst, is desorbed from the surface and move away from the surface, and the catalyst is set free to repeat the cycle again. So first of all, the hydrogen and the ethene, they are adsorbed on the surface, they diffuse into the catalyst surface, and second step is that they get adsorbed on the surface of the catalyst. This may be either chemisorption or physisorption. Third step is the reaction between ethene and hydrogen on the surface of catalyst to form an intermediate complex. The fourth step is decomposition of the intermediate complex into product. Intermediate complex is highly unstable, therefore as soon as it is formed, it changes into the products, and these products are ethane in this case, is desorbed from the surface and diffuses away from the surface. The catalyst is set free to once again repeat the cycle. This cycle may be repeated again and again. Now during the adsorption, the heat is released. During the adsorption of reactants, heat is released, and this heat is used to perform the chemical reaction. This heat of adsorption is used in formation of the products. We can quote the second example, which is the synthesis of ammonia by Haber process. Second example is the formation of ammonia by Haber process from nitrogen and hydrogen gases in the presence of iron catalyst. Now in this case, first step is we have iron as catalyst. The hydrogen and nitrogen gas, they diffuse into the catalyst and get adsorbed on the surface of catalyst through chemical bonds or van der Waals forces. First step is diffusion of gases. Second step is adsorption of gases on the surface of iron. Third step is the chemical reaction between nitrogen and hydrogen, forming an intermediate complex. Is a reaction leading to formation of complex, and this step is repeated again and again until ammonia is formed. Product is formed. In the third step, reaction leads to intermediate complex. This intermediate complex then changes into the product. Product is formed, product formation. And the fifth step is desorption of the product from the surface of the catalyst. Desorption and diffusion of ammonia from the catalyst. The catalyst is set free once again to take another molecule of nitrogen, and nitrogen desorption leading to free catalyst, and this catalyst may be recycled to take, catalyst may repeat the cycle. Thus, these are the five main steps of adsorption theory of catalysis. Allah Hafiz.